I'm Evelyn Allred. I'm the principal at Empire Elementary School, and we want to say thank you to Carson City Partnership for giving us this grant so that we can run our after-school robotics program.
My name is Rena Huntington. I'm a second grade teacher at Empire Elementary School. I run the Lego Robotics Club here. I received $1,000 to buy 3 more robotic kits to go with the 12 robotic kits that we already had that were currently not used. So I started a robotics club because I had recently taken a class on Lego robotics through NASA and Georgia Tech, and it was time for me to put my skills to use.
My name is Jackson. I'm 9. This is
I'm Johnny. I'm 9 too.
We are going to talk about the Lego Mindstorms robot and programming.
I'm May and I'm 8 years old. I'm Leah and I'm 7 years. I'm 7 and a half.
Brandon.
Andy. And how old are you?
10.
How old are you?
7.
7.
8.
I'm Tristan and I'm 11 years old.
I'm Efren Ramirez and I'm 10 years old.
11, I mean.
We started in probably March, and March or February or March. We started with one motor.
Around a month or two.
What I think that is the best part of this is that you can practically do anything with it.
We're building a Lego program, and it like it moves around and it walks like and it picks up these and it has sensors and like different features.
And then we put this thing where I could see.
There are 4 sensors. There is an ultrasonic sensor, which it sees things and makes the robot go around it, or it can bash into it.
It's so you can have it follow a black line.
Did you give it a name?
Yeah. And it's gonna walk like that.
Yeah, buddy.
There is a sound sensor where you make the sound, where you say something to it. If it detects sound, it will go forward, backwards, sideways, so on. There is a touch sensor where if you touch it, it will make the robot do something.
I'm building like this kind of robotics things, and I'm charging mine to see what it can do.
And then like making it dance too.
Probably around today we might finish.
Yeah, today we might finish.
Or this week we might have to program, and then next week we might finish.
Because we just have like, we have 5 pages
left. Maybe today I might finish because I'm already programming.
One of the benefits of working with robotics is teaching the kids to problem solve. If kids are able to solve their own problems and think critically, they carry that life skill with them forever.
We took off the head because at first it was looking down, then it was like that, so it has to be like this.
Do
Put it in the front of it.
It is.
Okay, now do it again.
I'm gonna do a turn.
So it's looking for the black line.
Here, I'll put it on the
okay. There it goes. Okay. It's going to keep looking. So give it a minute. And what it will do is it's going to keep going in a circle.
It's hard.
That one's just going in circles.
We need a... I think it's our wires.
It might be the wires, but I'm also seeing a shadow in there. I need to check the light sensor degrees in that.
And when we attached this, it was kind of hard because we had to figure out where to put it because it's really complicated. Then we figured out, we put it on the middle one. We attached it in the bottom like that because we thought it would be at the top, but we figured out it would be in the bottom. And then we didn't know which number, so we just tried all the numbers, and then number 2 worked best.
This is how many times that wheel goes around, okay? So, how many rotations do you want it to go forward? Okay, it's operating on something else, or it's very sensitive to the sound in the
room.
Okay, so again, stop it, because it's still running, but it's not doing anything. Okay, so if you say something, it'll go. If you don't do anything, it's reacting to the sound around here. We can adjust the sound so it hears.
These are kids in first grade through fifth grade who have taken their time after school to come in and do science experiments and mechanical experiments with robots, and their end result is the building of the robots and seeing how active they are.
This one went, this is the one we told you that followed the black line. It was pretty easy to plug in because we did that one before that one. And when we finish putting the head on the correct way, we're going to try and program it. The head has to be straight. Yeah.
We're going to download the same program.
Hello.
Okay, that I have here for Jackson. Okay. Well, so what do you think about this? Is it fun?
Yeah.
You can find,
there's so many in here. Okay.
35
cm.
And we're trying to make the robot walk. So if we took this out, if we undid that, then it wouldn't do anything if we just unplugged it. And this is the power where it works.
Oh, it'll probably take a few months for it to get there, but it'd be really cool if you guys could go and see. But this is, some of the pictures in here, you're gonna see pieces of the space shuttle. Now do you remember the big orange?
Here's when we were putting the two motors together. It's something that can hear it. So when it hears something, it just wants to do it.
They are really expensive. Lots of fun things you can do with it. It's just fun.
When you program it, there is practically anything you can do with it. And this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking of getting a robot and making it like a moving robot, a robot who can move arms and legs.
We want kids to learn how to be engineers, and Legos are one of the best engineering tools around, and even NASA astronauts will tell you that those are the best toys they've ever played with, and they continue to use them to help them create new ideas for new spaceships.